Thank you. Good afternoon. My name is Christina Olstad. My pronouns are she, her, hers. And today I'm going to share with you some takeaways from my own leadership journey that you can apply to yours. I fully realize that I am between you and the rest of your afternoon. So I want to acknowledge that first off. And so I'm going to be really focused on my time. So the three things I want to focus on today are being intentional, finding your joy, and building connections. And I chose the right clicker. There's two clickers up here. Perfect. All right, being intentional. You must be focused on your own path and journey. Things don't often happen by accident, although truth be told, I did fall into the field of student affairs, and I will tell you that story later. I personally use vision boards, and so does Oprah, to be focused and intentional throughout each year. Several years ago, I started a new family tradition. I was inspired by a brief one-minute video by a Google executive coach talking about the use of mind mapping. It's a process where you put the year in the center and spokes coming off of the year of topic areas you want to focus on for that year. Things such as family, financial, work-life balance, or abstract concepts like freedom. For each of the categories, you go into detail about how you want to be intentional about focusing on that for the year. So back to my family tradition. I proposed we did the same activity. It was a New Year's Eve, and I was describing it, and I pulled up the video for my family to watch. My brother said to me, "Is this like an HR activity?" Yes, it was like an HR activity. And you know what's funny about that? I tell you this, the things we put down on those cards happened. My wife and I both separately wrote down on our cards that we wanted to grow our family. And now we have a little guy named Robert. He goes by Bobby and he's 2 years old. My brother-in-law, the one who was skeptical about this activity, wrote down and put it in the universe that he wanted to get married to his fiance, who was also there, within that next year, and that happened as well. My mother-in-law talked about focusing on her fitness and wellness, and she wanted to do a handstand. She's in her 70s, and you know what? She's in better shape than me, and she did that handstand. I'll focus on my fitness later. So things often don't happen unless you intentionally plan for how you're going to get there, and you put them out into the universe. And that helps to hold you accountable for making it happen. Another way to be intentional is focusing on your strengths. I've personally used the Clifton Strength Finder tool to identify my top 5 talent themes that can be cultivated into strengths over time. My top strength identified is a learner. I love learning and applying what I learn to my job. I enjoy finding new information, approaches to solve complex issues. We should talk later. I really enjoyed that last session and my background's in social work. It's important for you to explore your strengths and to turn them into true assets in your work and life. Explore the various tools that are out there, such as Strength Finder, Emotional Intelligence, and the Thomas Kilman Inventory on Conflict Resolution, for example, to learn more about your strengths and style. Next, I want to focus on finding your joy. I love my job. I'm the Dean of Students here at UW-Madison. I thrive in a fast-paced work environment, crisis management and response, striving to build inclusive campus communities. I say striving because we have to continually enhance the experience for all of our students on campus. The area I oversee is student advocacy, which ties in my educational background in social work and enhancing the student experience. I often do a session titled Intentionally Crafting Your Career Path, and it focuses on utilizing tools, networks, and resources where you currently are and where you want to be. Back to that vision board activity just last year. Now, I'm the new Dean of Students. I started here in July. And last year on my vision board, I put launch a national job search, and I wanted to land at a Research One large public institution. And look at where I am today. I put it out in the universe, and I make it happen. So I personally use a professional development plan every single year, where I focus on my learning edges, what state and national conventions I plan to attend, who I will reach out to at peer and aspirant institutions to continually evolve our work and to meet the needs of our students. I even get specific about who on this very campus I want to continue to build relationships with and how I plan to go about doing that. I hold myself accountable with my plan by writing it down, but I'm also flexible with my plan and things change. That ties into being open to changing course. I mentioned earlier that I fell into the field of student affairs. I went to college at Augsburg University. It was called Augsburg College at the time in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And the saying back then was that Augsburg puts out preachers, teachers, and social workers. My plan was to be a teacher and a coach. I played ice hockey and soccer, and that was my plan. Then I took a perspective course called Exploring Human Services. It was a J-term class. All of January, I did this specific course. And I volunteered at the MS Achievement Center in St. Paul, Minnesota. I did this because I wanted to learn more about MS, and I wanted to do something to give back, and also to learn about the ways to serve individuals with MS. After that class, I changed my major to social work. Now, when I shared this with my father, who really wanted me to be an accountant, I was a first-generation college student, and my sister majored in dance, and I majored in social work. And I remember my dad being like, I really thought you should go into business. And I said, you know, I just feel really drawn to social work and a profession and giving back. And what's interesting is that my sister, who majored in dance, she had a similar conversation with my father. She now oversees development at the Skirball Theater at NYU, and I'm the dean of students at Wisconsin. So your passion, you can turn your passion into incredible opportunities. When I was a senior in college, I worked overnight as a security officer for the campus. One night, I was walking in Old Main around 3 a.m., and it was just myself, dark building, just my flashlight out. And as I walked through that building, a board caught my eye. It was a job board, and I had walked in this same building thousands of times before, and I never noticed this board. And I thought, I'm a senior, I'm about to graduate, and I need to start thinking about what's next. And as I walked up to that job board, I saw the position for a part-time hall director. And I thought, I interface often with the residence life staff here on campus as a security officer, and that this would be an opportunity for me to utilize my skills in social work. I applied and I received that position, hence me kind of falling into the field of student affairs. Within the first 2 months, I was promoted to full-time hall director, and within the first year, complex director. I'm still in the field of student affairs and have loved the journey that the field has taken me on. I'm so grateful that I looked up and I paid attention. The field has allowed me to travel the world through my experience on semester at sea, a shipboard campus where I spent 2.5 months traveling the Mediterranean and crossing the Atlantic Ocean twice. I've lived in Minnesota, Maine, Vermont, Maryland, and now Wisconsin. I love what I do every day, and I often pull from my educational background in social work. When I think about the moments where I have the most joy in what I do, I'm reminded of several cards and interactions I've had over the years with students. I worked with a young man at a previous institution to secure access to housing and meals. And during the week of graduation, he came to my office with a card in his hand. I remember seeing his smiling face, which a few months before was a face of despair. He handed me the card and it read, I prayed and I found myself in your office.
Your success in life puts you in a place to help me with mine, and for that, I'm forever grateful. He signed it his name and his class year, and we still stay in touch to this day. That's why I do what I do every day. Failure also is a part of the process. Rejection is difficult, but what I've found over the years is that things work out exactly how they're meant to be. Being turned down for a position can be a blow, but what you do with it, that's what you're measured on. When I was in college, I took a course, Philosophy of Medieval and Renaissance Times. It was to fulfill another one of those perspectives. And man, I struggled in that class. I ended up barely passing that class, good enough to not have to take it again, but bad that it brought down my GPA. I didn't let one grade define me, and I focused on doing better in my classes for the future. Failure is going to happen. You'll not get every job you apply for. And at times, you will receive a bad grade. It's how you respond and focus your efforts moving forward that are indicators of resilience. In the New York Times best-selling book, The Road to Character, by David Brooks, he talks about humility as radical honesty with yourself. Understanding you have to give to receive, surrender yourself to get strength within yourself, and have to conquer your desires to get what you want. In order to fulfill yourself, sometimes you have to forget yourself. Finally, building connections. Throughout my career, I've built up relationships with trusted mentors, advisors, and colleagues who I can turn to. I refer to this community as my personal board of directors. If I'm dealing with a particularly challenging issue, I can reach out to brainstorm to receive advice and counsel from my board. I've cultivated these relationships throughout my 20 years in student affairs. I stay in touch with my personal board through connecting at conference, sending holiday cards, texts, and scheduling phone conversations. My alma mater, the University of Vermont, where I pursued my doctorate in educational leadership and policy studies, allowed me to join this organization called the Vermont Connection, a network that is large and well-established in student affairs. And I always look forward to the TVC reception at our national conventions. The Vermont Connection and relationships I've nurtured through TVC have provided opportunities for national service roles through the Placement Exchange, which is the largest student affairs placement conference. I've stayed connected to TVC throughout my years as a professional and truly value my colleagues that I work with through the Higher Education Student Affairs Master's Program, doctoral program, and through my close to 6 years working at the University of Vermont campus. So you may be asking yourself, how do you cultivate your own personal board of directors? Some of it takes time and through building relationships with trusted faculty or staff. Sometimes you join a network by the college or university that you attend. When you see someone who inspires you and you want to what they have, engage in a conversation about their story. How did they get to where they are today? Most people, not all people, but most people love telling you their journey. Ask them questions. Invite someone to coffee or lunch that you're curious to learn more about their path. Being a part of UW-Madison, you have incredible faculty and staff at your fingertips to cultivate as part of your personal board. I've continually built my board of directors over time. I know who to call, I know when to call, and they will always be honest with me. They'll ask me what my role is, and I know they're always in my corner. When you graduate from the University of Wisconsin-Madison, you join a vast network that has alumni chapters in more than 75 cities worldwide to continue to build your personal board wherever the first, second, or third role in your career takes you. The key is to intentionally cultivate your connections through your career and to mentor newer professionals to give back and honestly to stay relevant about changing trends. So in closing, I challenge you to be intentional, find your joy, and build your own personal board of directors. Thank you, and on Wisconsin.